in this edition of Art Loft, Key West in the Florida Keys, from the Rock House Masterpieces Gallery, Mosaic of the Keys.
We give out 400 canvases in November and December. They're blank canvases, and we give them to artists and aspiring artists of all levels.
Roberta Marx, a retrospective.
She's worked in many different mediums, including pottery, paintings, mixed media, and construction. So this exhibit really brings together a lot of elements that she's worked in.
The Play Project.
The Play Project brings actors here from our community in Key West, directors from our community, writers from our community, and combines them with actors, directors, and writers.
Independence Day, Conk Republic style.
There are some that come by accident. There are many that come here specifically for the festival. It is something that is enjoyed by many around the world and across the country.
It's all ahead on this edition of Art Loft.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by...
In the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show. And every day is another masterpiece.
This project is sponsored in part by the Department of State, Division of Cultural Affairs, the Florida Council of Arts and Culture, and the State of Florida. With the support of the Miami-Dade County Department of Cultural Affairs and the Cultural Affairs Council, the Miami-Dade County Mayor, and the Board of County Commissioners.
Hi, art lovers. I'm Kalyn James, welcoming you to this special edition of Art Loft. For this episode, our road trip through the gorgeous Florida Keys brings us back to the arts community of Key West. Today, our gracious host location is the Rock House Masterpieces Gallery. And joining me now is the gallery's director, Marco. Marco, thanks so much for having us.
We're happy to have you here, Kalyn.
This is such a special place. Tell us a little bit about what people can expect when they walk through the doors.
Well, our gallery is a little bit different than other galleries in town in that we're housed in an old church. We have furniture, we have artwork, and it all kind of mixes together. We have 20 different artists here, handmade, one-of-a-kind sculptures, and we feel that it's a great mix for our collectors.
It really is, and this furniture is like art as well. It is so beautiful.
It's all handmade. It's made in Fiji, and our collectors get to choose which leathers they want, the colors. We have all different shades and skins and hides, and it makes it a special selection process, which our collectors really enjoy.
And speaking of special, I know that you also have special events here for the community. Tell us a bit about that.
We do. We've had weddings, receptions. We have art shows all the time here. And we even have a magic mind reader who comes once a week, and people really enjoy coming for that event.
Well, I know Art Loft was able to catch one of those special events, and we want to share that with our audience. So take a look.
Hi, I'm Joan Becker, and I'm a painter from Philadelphia and Key West. I'm in the gallery here. I have about 7 or 8 pieces here in Key West, which has been very good for me. I've wanted to paint a drag queen for years, and I have never had the space to do it. So this is my opportunity.
My name is Inga, and I'm a drag queen here in Key West. And today I'm getting painted by the awesome artist, Joan Becker. She wanted something fun to paint, so she picked me. It's great.
I paint from life, and when I paint figures, I try to connect with the person that I paint and find sort of their spiritual center and communicate with them the entire time I paint. It's very nice, and it's very much Key West. It is, you know, Inga is the big star of Key West, and there's a lot of art here, so it's a natural for us.
Art Loft isn't the only crew touring the Florida Keys. During our trip, we learned about the traveling exhibition, Mosaic of the Keys. For this project, artists and residents of Monroe County dipped their brushes to create hundreds of paintings on many canvases. Once gathered, the eclectic mosaic set to make its way from Key Largo to here, where we finally caught up with it in Key West.
Our board and staff were really looking for a project that would give awareness of the arts and how the arts touches all the communities up and down the Keys. So we call it the Connections Project. This is our fourth year, so I will say that we have refined it.
We give out 400 canvases in November and December. They're blank canvases, and we give them to artists and aspiring artists of all levels.
We ask them to be aware of the fact that the whole project's gonna move 7 times. And then we collate the whole thing into the big project of all the returned canvases, not knowing at all what we're gonna get. And then we do receptions with a big kickoff in Key Largo, and then we work our way down the Keys. And now we're here in Key West at our very last stopping place. And one of the great things about being at the Gatto is that it's a public building, and it's one of those great historic venues in Key West that have been restored and used on a daily basis. We have beautiful murals and a little, almost little cigar makers museum in the front entrance. Our goal initially was to sort of have 60-40, 60 professional artists and 40% community members.
Because these are 6x6 canvases, and they're great for experimentation and for trying out new things. We will have different mediums, collage mediums, acrylics, watercolor, not oils generally.
We have a lot of multimedia. There's lots of oceans and palm trees. And actually we have some very wonderful photographers.
There seems to often be a tropical theme to it. And you'll see one that really complements another, so we'll do a little bit of tweaking here and there. The Mosaic Project is a fundraiser for the Arts Council. For a donation, you get a thank you gift of one of these canvases, and it's randomly selected.
And then we pack them up in envelopes and ship them in May, so everybody gets this great surprise in the mail when they're done.
We do have a list that's available at each one of the receptions, and it's fun for people to look on there and see, oh, I want to know if so-and-so did one, and see that that person did participate, and then go on a little scavenger hunt to try and find that person's work. Of course, everybody who makes a canvas is really excited to see it in this wonderful mosaic of almost 400 canvases.
And people sort of marvel at it, and nobody picks the same favorite. You know, everybody finds something that speaks to them.
And they'll bring their friends, and then their friends are like, I want to do that next year.
For more information, including how you can help support the arts in the beautiful Florida Keys, visit keysarts.com. Up next, on Art Loft.
The play project brings actors here from our community in Key West, directors from our community, writers from our community, and combines them with actors, directors, and writers.
At the Key West Art and Historical Society, we take in an exhibition of the collective works of local multimedia artist Roberta Marks. This retrospective focuses on the progression of her work throughout her career. Join us as we learn more.
Roberta Marks is a local artist. She lived down here in the Keys since 1981, so she's been a long-term artist down here. This is a retrospective. She's worked in many different mediums, including pottery, paintings, mixed media, and construction. So this exhibit really brings together a lot of elements that she's worked in. There definitely are elements from her early career in here all the way through works that have just been created specifically for this show. So you can see works that she's created in the 1970s all the way up through now. So you can see her progression of works, what her influences are, and actually the materials with which she was working with. Roberta actually has her master's in fine art, so she's studied, or she hasn't picked it up recreationally or learned it through small classes here in town. So to have that caliber of artists in town, that definitely reflects in the way that the exhibit, the material that's in the exhibit and the way that it's laid out. So it's definitely not what people expect when they come into the museum from a local Key West artist. Roberta has incorporated a lot of different elements into her artwork. A lot of them are found objects, whether it be things found locally that people are discarding, things that she finds on walks. She's also picked up a lot of pieces on her travels. She's been around the world, so a lot of her pieces incorporate elements from those countries and give her a reflection on where she's been. And what she does is assemble them together with other objects that either she's created or for assemblies, for instance, she puts them into boxes or containers to really exemplify the message she's trying to get across. I think the tone of the show is something that people are not necessarily expecting when they walk in. People expect bright colors, blues and purples and pinks, and you walk in here and you really have that a darker tone. She incorporates a lot of grays, a lot of blacks, a lot of whites, keeps to a very neutral palette, and I think that's reflective of what she is exemplifying in her artwork and the place that she's reaching inside to bring out in her artwork. There's definitely a few pieces in here that stand out more than others. For instance, there's a piece called Retro One, and that actually has Charlie Hebdo, the French satirical newspaper. She actually collected quite a few of their issues, and what it is a really a nice piece that honors those folks who died at the hands of people that were unhappy with the material that Charlie Hebdo was putting out there. So that's definitely a standout piece for me in the exhibit. So in the exhibit, there are a few placards next to pieces of the artwork. The text that's on them came directly from the artist. It sort of describes either where she acquired the material or where she made the material or where she actually made the artwork and what it means to her and the message that it's trying to convey. It's not with every piece that's in the exhibit, but with select pieces that she felt really had a deep meaning and wanted our visitors to have a better understanding of her artwork. I think the pieces that have inspired either the most questions or the most comments about have been the pieces that contain things that belong to children. That really resonates with our visitors. A lot of our visitors have children with them, and so it's something that they identify with, and it begs the question of why she incorporates that into a lot of her artwork. You know, did something happen to her as a child? Did she experience something with her own children? So we've had a lot of questions and comments from our visitors about that. We decided to put the exhibit together now because Roberta's been here and working in Key West for the last over 30 years, actually. And we thought with the quality of her work that it was time to honor her with a retrospective. We asked her what she would like to do, the direction it would like to take. This was really a collaborative effort on our part and the artist's part. And she wanted to incorporate old pieces and new to really make it very full and show the range of her skills and diversity over the last 30 and 40 years. Two things I would like the visitors to take away. One, I'd like them to understand the breadth and depth of the artistry that occurs in Key West itself. This is not your typical artwork that people associate with the island, and I think on the surface it actually shows how much Key West relies on its cultural diversity. The other thing to take away from it is the artist's work herself. She has put her heart and soul into the artwork, and I think we would love our visitors to understand the process which she goes through and the delicate nature with which she assembles a lot of her pieces.
For a list of current exhibitions at the Key West Art and Historical Society, visit kwahs.org. Up next on Art Loft.
There are some that come by accident. There are many that come here specifically for the festival. It is something that is enjoyed by many around the world and across the country.
Now we head over to the studios of Key West for the first run of the Play Project. This collaboration of producers aimed to show audiences the process of developing plays from script to stage, and Art Loft was there.
You get this thing about, I don't know if she said this to anyone else about her mom.
Yeah.
Do you know what
the
I mean?
Studios of Key West provides a place from artists from all the disciplines to explore, develop, and grow. And we have become a part of that.
That's not what we discussed.
I know, grandmother.
Not what we discussed.
The Play Project brings actors here from our community in Key West, directors from our community, writers from our community, and combines them with actors, directors, and writers from other theatrical communities. And we use a new play that has not seen a life of its own yet. And we, in this period of time, develop that new play and get it ready to be on its feet for the first time in the simplest of production requirements. It's really about working on the play.
In general, I write stuff that's meant to just be like, you look at each other and you go.
Yeah. There's something really special about actually being welcomed into a community, and there's such a rich history here in Key West of theater, of writing, of art, and the opportunity to be welcomed in by the local artists and get to work with the local artists and get them to get to know me and meet them a little bit was something that I was really, really excited about.
This is the pilot program. This is the first time the studios, who have been really supportive and wonderful with this idea, have basically allowed us to start this project here in this space, which is an extremely exciting space here in Key West for all artists.
What Murphy and Wendy are trying to do here is to honor this community but also build a bridge to the national theater community. Is that this? That's something very unique and special that this place has to offer.
For more about the Play Project and more from the studios of Key West, visit skw.org. And now for a party unlike any other, the annual Conch Republic Independence Celebration. For over 30 years, Key West has hosted this two-week springtime celebration in honor of the city's brief secession from the United States. Join us as we take to the streets of Key West for this colorful gathering of folks from near and far.
My name is Michaela Anderson, and I am involved in the Conch Republic days because my father was Sir Peter Anderson, the Secretary General of the Conch Republic, and I have grown up with this entire festival and the environment of the Conch Republic. The Conch Republic celebration celebrates our independence from the U.S., which resulted from a blockade that the U.S. Border Patrol put up. They put that up illegally, which caused beer trucks and tourists to stop coming. So our mayor, Dennis Wardlow, at the time went to the courthouse steps and declared our independence from the U.S. So every year, the Coast Guard acts as U.S. Border Patrol, and we reenact our secession from the United States in a great battle. We have a myriad of events, from everything to our unique drag races, which involves our drag queens racing each other in an obstacle course. We have our bed races, a local's favorite, where teams gather and create their own beds and push a team member down the course in their bed. We also have our first annual Freshwater Conch Gala. I'm very excited about this year, celebrating our freshwater conchs who have lived here for 7 years or more. We also have our world's longest parade, which runs from the Gulf of Mexico to the Atlantic Ocean. as well as our great battle, of course, reenacting our independence, and many other fun events. There are some that come by accident. There are many that come here specifically for the festival. It is something that is enjoyed by many around the world and across the country, and something that people look forward to joining us in every year. Long live the Conch Republic, and long live each and every one of you.
For more information about upcoming events in gorgeous Key West and the Florida Keys, visit flakeys.com.
Ahoy there! I'm Lily Lynch, and you're watching Art Loft on South Florida PBS.
Our time here in Key West is almost up, but before we go, take a look at all these fun stops made during our road trip through the Florida Keys.
The name of the gallery, Dog Tired, is because I do a lot of pet portraiture. I am mainly a watercolor artist. I've been painting strictly in watercolor for about 28 years now. And although I deviate sometimes, I'll mix it in with some acrylic sometimes, or I do acrylic collage. I basically do watercolor. I do a lot of pet portraiture work for people, and I used to just strictly do that. When I originally opened the space, that was my intention. And then I decided to invite some of my friends along the way, and it's turned into this eclectic group of people that I know. This gallery, it's growing on its own. It has a life of its own, and it's just constantly evolving. Artists come in and I see their work, and if I feel like it connects with the space and they connect with me and I connect with them, then we give it a shot. The art that you see in this gallery, you're not going to see anywhere else here on the island. It's only represented by me, and it represents the island, or what people that came here that are artists, what they felt. I hope that they leave here with a good experience, feeling good. I like them to come in and feel like they're coming into my house, my living room, and enjoying some of my art.
Thanks so much for joining us on this stop of our road trip through the Florida Keys. Let Art Loft inspire your creativity every day. Visit WPBT2.org/Art Loft to watch past episodes. And get social with us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Art Loft SFL. I'm Kalyn James, reminding you to stay creative. Bye. Come on.
Woo, yay!
Yes. Good with me too. Can you see these when I'm here? For the inaugural run, hate that word. Can I say first run? Thank you. Thank you. It's the fire wagon. And there's, I guess, the explosions from the fire. The horses. Join us as we learn more. Okay, no more explosions, right? Bring it to the United States.
Thanks for having me. No, you like that, huh?
How about that, huh? It doesn't get any better than that.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by...
In the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show. And every day is another masterpiece.
This project is sponsored in part by the Department of State, Division of Cultural Affairs, the Florida Council of Arts and Culture, and the State of Florida. With the support of the Miami-Dade County Department of Cultural Affairs and the Cultural Affairs Council, the Miami-Dade County Mayor, and the Board of County Commissioners.